Morgan. I'm a product manager here at SciAps.
And my name is Ben Boutour. I work with SciAps as well, here with Morgan.
What are we going to talk about?
Well, let's talk about low gold performance in rock samples, because that's a common question we get. You know, historically, you have not been able to do, with any sort of reliability, low gold measurements in geologic samples. So I understand there's some improvements. What, maybe you can kind of fill us in.
Yeah, so I mean, there's always been a few challenges with measuring low gold. And, you know, for one, people always want to measure the lowest gold possible because it can be pretty profitable to mine gold, even when it's at low levels, like say like 1 ppm or down, or even less sometimes, right?
Yeah.
So and the tough part is with handheld XRF, 1 ppm is about the best you could do for any element in the ideal sample. So we're really pushing it to its limits in terms of detection limits. And the other issue is that gold has peaks in the spectrum that overlap with a lot of other common elements that are in samples like these. So things like zinc and arsenic are kind of the two of the main culprits, but even mercury and a few others that, to a lesser degree, that can really kind of overlap with the gold peaks and make it really hard to measure. And then thirdly, gold can be kind of nuggety, right? So it's not always finely dispersed and homogeneous throughout the sample. So an XRF is only going to see it if it's in the field of view of the X-ray. So, and that's roughly 5 millimeters or so in diameter. So you really got to hit the spot with the gold to see it. In this model, the X-505, we've got the top of the line silicon drift detector. What that gives us is really good spectral resolution and higher count rates. So with higher count rates, you get better sensitivity, lower detection limits, better statistics in general. And with higher resolution, you can start to kind of separate some of those peaks that overlap pretty severely. So better resolution helps with that issue. The 505, great detector, really powerful tube. So it's a real high-end portable XRF in a super small and lightweight package. Software-wise, we've put a ton of time into the algorithms that go into actually processing the spectrum. And one key component of that is what we call deconvolution, where you're separating the peaks from each other and saying, these X-rays belong to gold, these X-rays belong to zinc, for example. So we spent a lot of time on refining that to ensure that this analyzer is the absolute best possible when it comes to analytical performance. So I see you've got a sample there.
So we've got Arrays 27A. So this is a standard from Ore Research out of Australia.
Arrays 277, is that right?
Is it 279?
Who labeled this sample anyway? 279.
279, thank you. So Arrays 279, this is this is low gold. I think it's like 7 parts per million gold.
So, yeah, roughly, yeah.
So we're going to take a shot here. Arrays 279.
277, right? Numbers are hard.
Whatever one is, yeah. Comes in at 7 ppm.
All right, 5.5 ppm.
5.5.
How long was that test?
That was a 12-second test. So I'm gonna run it again.
We'll
see what the repeatability looks like. And so obviously, the gold is, 7 ppm is quite rich in the world of gold, ore deposits. But all right, so we got 4.3 ppm on this, plus or minus 2.5 with the air. So, if you count for that, we're, within the right range of 7 ppm gold on this sample, a little low. This is a 12-second test. The longer you test with XRF, the better your precision gets, better your accuracy you'll get. So, that's a pretty quick test for low gold. If we tested for 30 seconds or longer, I would expect it to improve.
And you could potentially see lower levels of gold as well with as you test for longer, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, thanks. So yeah, no, and then we've got arsenic, you know, zinc, you know, there's some gold pathfinders in here that you would also look at. You know, typically the way people use XRF for gold, gold exploration is they use pathfinder elements. So elements that have a tight correlation with gold, might be silver, might be arsenic, you know, base metals. There's a whole bunch of them depending on the you know, deposit type, but now you get gold as well, and it's sort of another layer of confirmation of the presence of gold. So
even though gold can be tricky, it's not your only thing you can look at if you're actually, you know, mining or exploring for gold, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, okay. Great. Well, thanks, Ben.
Thank you, Morgan.